I've done a great deal to get this really ready to go. Everything's cut to shape and the Velcro sewn on. And all four of these pieces come in a little pack that's set of four. And this Velcro is set up with the doorway has the smooth side, and the door is going to roll up on the outside of the house. So we want the Velcro on the inside. The Velcro is going to be facing out on these pieces that go on the side that it locks onto. And you can see how it's set up here. All you need to do is get the Velcro up on these side pieces. They're cut to shape. And we've got a small piece that's going to go up above the door. This is the door that's going to roll up. It's got the sewn pocket in the bottom, just like our side curtains do. All right, covering the end wall. We can start on either side. These little shorties or W's are handy on top. I'm actually gonna place one down here as well. First thing I wanna do is index where this Velcro is. So I need it to come up to the top of the doorway and be outside the doorway. Pretty easy to just get a rough idea where that's gonna go. Then I can come up to the top and start wiring my way down. Before I start really pulling on this to get it good and fit, I want to put a wire in the top, temporarily at least. It's going to just keep it from pulling down when I pull on it. It's really nice when you're putting on any of this woven poly. Give it a little stretch now and then, and it really just gets it sitting so much nicer. It's just going to have less puckers in it as it So I've wired from top to bottom, keeping the Velcro about a half an inch outside the channel. The next thing I'm going to do is get this thing positioned side to side. You can choose to do the end wall ahead of time if you want to, and then you don't have to deal with this at all, or you could just set it aside while you're working on the end wall. You want to get it roughly straight. This is going to help it go on without wrinkles again. So I can just see real easily, if I pull it too high, it's too high. If I pull it too low, it's wrinkling up that way. Just get it in the middle. Leave it a little bit loose because you're going to be fastening it in between, and it takes a little bit of slack each time you wire an upright. That's enough to hold it in place. I take a wire and start working across the bottom. Each time I get to an upright, if I cross this upright, I might get it so tight it would be hard to get the wire in. So before I cross the upright, I'm gonna take another wire, start working my way up from the bottom. That way I've got just a little bit of slack I need to get started on that wire. It just makes it easier. You just run that one up that far for now. Continue across the bottom. Anytime you don't like it, it's easy to back up a little bit. Just get it a little snugger, whatever it is you're trying to accomplish. You can do this anytime. Come to another upright. I've got just enough slack still. I didn't pull that so tight. Get the wire in. I kind of like to roll it in with my finger, see that it's rolling in nice, then wire it. Just a little technique. So after we've got these sides in place, we wired across the bottom, we wired up each of these, and we just put some little W's in the top of it to tack it, because our top poly is going to come over and get a full piece of wire. Then it's just a matter of taking the door and sticking it right to the Velcro where we want it to be, and then taking our top panel and putting it over the doorway. We wire across where the door and this top panel cross, and we put in these little double-sided Velcros that are going to be able to catch that roll-up panel when we roll it up. And this is great to have these two different pieces, because two things happen. One, this panel acts as a little bit of a water break so that we can roll this door up and it sheds water out of it, so we're not getting a lot of water in it. And also, these two can be changed independently. This thing's probably never going to wear out up above, but you might end up driving through your door, damaging it, having some wind damage, something like that. It's super easy. Take this wire back out, replace just the door panel, and you're back to a brand new end wall. Once we've got all four panels in place, just like we had the roll bar on the side curtain, we're gonna put a roll bar in this door panel. And we need it just to be long enough to overlap a little bit at each end. Same thing, we're gonna put clips on it near the bottom. And then we can just roll the panel right up. If you're tall and you want this thing up all the way tight, you can, this Velcro can position anywhere you want. And there you've got that little flap to keep the rain out. But if you're not as tall and you don't really need the height all the time, just roll it up any place you can reach. And put a little bit of Velcro on there, and that's plenty. We've got the two positions. We put that in there, a length that most people can reach. When it's at the bottom, we're gonna want a little extra protection from the wind. So we're gonna drive these posts in that just create a little pocket. We'll drive those in about halfway. And that way, when these come back down, we've got something that keeps the wind from even being able to blow on that in any way at all. The other thing we do is we've moved this Velcro to the outside, so the overlap where this locks is to the outside of this channel. So anytime you think there's going to be super high winds, or if you just want to close it all winter long, you can close this doorway. You could even do this with just a couple short pieces here and there, and you're going to turn this into a permanent panel on your house so it can't blow around in the wind at all. This way we're finding that we get really good life out of this poly. Very economical way to cover an end wall, and we can really put value to where you can really use it growing in this hoop house. That's an end wall covered.
Call us anytime you need some help, and we'd be glad to talk you through any of these steps. Thank you.